I think that's absurd. People say, let Mother Nature take its course. That's crazy. The people have a devil-may-care attitude about it because it's not their property.
All the time. Clock was ticking. The erosion continued.
When that house went in, I, only being their neighbor, felt such a pang of heartache. Oh, please stop this. I just can't go on. This was so horrible.
It is a day that the people who summer on the shores of Chatham won't soon forget. That day back in January when two houses were threatened by the ravaging sea and one house became its victim. For Joan Wilson, it is a painful memory.
It was like being told that a relative of yours was fatally ill and then watching him die, which I've just done with my dad. It was that kind of pain.
It is only when you're out here on the water that you can understand the magnitude of the problem, the waves hitting the boat that we're in, and of course lashing against the shoreline over there. If, as the residents say, this used to be nice and calm out here, well, it's not anymore. This is the Pleasant Bay vacationers have been drawn to for more than a century. A sandy beach that gently sloped to a quiet, peaceful bay that was what its name implied. In 1946, Joan Wilson's father chose this as the perfect spot for his family's summer home in this town called Chatham that they loved so much.
It was beautiful. It was soft. It was sandy, it was grassy, it was calm, it was peaceful.
It was that same peacefulness 50 years earlier that drew town selectman Tim Pennypacker's family to Chatham. But his seafaring father always knew that the peace of Pleasant Bay was fleeting, that one day the bay would turn on those who loved her.
Why did he know that so well?
Based on history. My father didn't have a crystal ball any more than any of the other old timers did. It was just a matter of based on history. It's a cyclical process. It's something that happened.
We'll tell you tomorrow night what happened to make this become this. In Chatham, Deborah Horne, Channel 12 News. The story of Chatham is a story of what Mother Nature giveth, she often taketh away. For nearly a century and a half, she gave this affluent community a beautiful, peaceful bay. But as surely as the tide rises and falls, she would take it all back.
943 Sierra, report midfield left down runway 16.
The reason lies here in this stretch of sandy beach that acts as a barrier between the relative calm of Chatham Harbor and the unforgiving ferocity of the Atlantic Ocean. Every 140 years or so, this barrier beach grows until the tidal tension on each side becomes so great it must find an outlet. So the beach simply splits in half. We call that split a breach.
Does that software package look like it's going to be all right?
Dr. Graham Geis has studied these waters with his colleagues at the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institute for a dozen years. The breach at Nauset Beach, he says, is part of a natural cycle.
It's an important part of the process which produces the estuaries and the harbors and the salt marshes and all of the coastal systems that are developed in behind barrier beaches.
But what is good for the ocean is proving devastating on land. No longer does Nauset Beach protect the fragile shoreline. And in January, this was the result.
But given the fact that the breakthrough was allowed to happen. Here.
To Peter Mason and his neighbors who spend summers on Pleasant Bay, nature is a force that man can reckon with and even beat. And he contends the town of Chatham and the state of Massachusetts are both letting nature have her way at his and his neighbors' expense.
It was allowed to happen. It could have easily been plugged up by an operator and a front end loader in a week using all the material that's out there at a very small cost of $20,000 to $30,000.
To go over there with a front-end loader and try to put up a sufficient amount of sand, say within a half a mile or a mile stretch where it is its weakest point, really is an exercise in futility, in my opinion, because it would break through somewhere else.
Should you fill it?
No, it's important to realize that, first place, you probably couldn't fill it, but let's imagine you could. If you had, then you would have been putting back into play the same set of forces which produced the breach in the first place.
If filling in the breach is not the answer, then what is? We'll have more on that tomorrow night. In Chatham, Deborah Horne, Channel 12 News.
A beautiful, quiet little beach, and we built our dune.
It was grassy, it was calm.
And after the break, out on the beach, out of beach came and just ate it all away.
It's a necessary part of the system.
The book of Matthew in the Bible, he who builds on the sand is a fool. Well, maybe that's borne out.
I never thought it would come to this. No. I never realized how powerful the ocean really can be.
In the 15 months since Nauset Beach split in half, no longer the barrier between the shore and the crashing waves of the Atlantic Ocean, the people of Chatham have had to renew their acquaintance with the force of Mother Nature. And they have had to give her grudging respect as they have tried, with decidedly mixed results, to blunt the force of her fury. Those who have watched their homes threatened by the sea blame the state and the town. Now they are suing Massachusetts for $10 million for doing nothing to save their home. The town could be sued next.
Now we have millions of dollars that have been lost, irreparable damage to some homes, let alone the anxiety and anguish of some who've watched all their land go, let alone a home.
I happen to be one of the residents too, and I would agree with them. The town did nothing. There wasn't anything the town could do. I feel for these people. I happen to be one of these people. I could be in jeopardy, you know, in 6 months from now, and fully realize that. But I can't get too worked up over it for the simple fact that we all chose to be here. We all chose to build here, knowing full well that nature and the elements can make drastic changes.
The breach at Nauset Beach affected not just the residents who every day lose a little bit more of their property, but nearly everyone who works and lives along the shore. And there are important lessons to be learned here, lessons our forefathers already knew.
Our forefathers who watched the sea more closely than we have, who were seafaring people, were really aware that the open shore was not a good place to build our houses, and they built their houses inland.
We'd want to protect it too, but ultimately what happens is going to happen, and I don't think that we have the financial resources nor any other ability to ultimately save this property if Mother Nature is going to really go full force to claim it.
Well, if you let nature decide, then pretty soon people will be standing up in Plymouth saying, oh yes, out there used to be a great little place called Cape Cod.
Deborah Horne, Channel 12 News.